So, I'm going to show you how I made a thumbnail for my YouTube video in Dall-E. So, here is pasting in two pictures I found on in Google. Elon Musk and Hillary, so I'm sizing up Hillary, to put it nicely, and moving her into position. Yeah, about there, and the size wise I wanted her a little bit bigger than Elon to make her like a bit menacing. So now I'm tracing around to take out the background, and the clue here is take a little bit of the hair and with you, so you don't get any like pixels like of the background. And the nice thing is that Dall-E just fills out the rest of the hair, make it look natural, so that's great. You don't have to spend much time on the details. So here we go. And now I place the frame where I want to fill out. So Dall-E will fill out what's deleted in the frame, what's missing. And I write finish the background, as easy as that. And I get four choices to choose between, and I went for this one. It seems quite natural, and the table looked nice. The table and the background just like auto-completed, so they look like they're in the same room. It's quite fascinating. And I finished that table over by Elon. And that's some spots I obviously seem to not be happy with, so I tried to just fix that small spot that was too shiny. And I went for that one, it looks okay. So now, the problem with the microphone that got cut off. So, it doesn't always work, this AI generation. So here I try to make the rest of the microphone. Shape is a bit, I'm gonna say it. And I just write what I want to have. But as you're gonna see, it didn't quite work out. It's quite ugly looking and not realistic. So what I actually end up doing is deleting, just removing the whole microphone. So I found that to be the easiest solution. Sometimes it can be time consuming if you want exactly something from the AI, because yeah, it's creative to put it nicely. So in the end I went for this one, and I thought the fingers maybe was a little bit off, the tip of the fingers. And I tried to write lady fingers. As you can see, it doesn't quite like that, some kind of filter. So I try again, just go with hand of a woman. And I actually put in no nail polish because I just want a clean look. But it's being a bit creative, so it throws it in anyway. Finally, I decide to just leave it because I'm probably gonna hide the arm behind a speech bubble, so it doesn't matter. So now it looks like this. I think it's really good. Looks like they're in the same room. So now I go into a website. This one is free. And I just make some speech bubbles. And some text. Only what I have to do after these speech bubbles is resizing it to be a good ratio for a thumbnail, which is 16:9. It's a bit too wide now, so I need to crop it in on the sides a bit. The left apparently hates Elon Musk. That's what the video is about. So, well, some final adjustments for the speech bubble, and then it's Elon's turn to get his speech bubble. Let's see. I think Elon has to be a little bit provocative, as he can be. So he's going to say woke virus. He needs to trigger the left for this thumbnail. So there we go. The full picture has this artifact from the AI's creation of it, the blue like sign. So we're gonna crop that out. I take the height and I multiply that by 1.77. That's the ratio of 16 divided by 9. So that gives me what the width should be. About 1600. So there you go. The finished result. The thumbnail is done. And mainly just used AI. The Dall-E system.